Alright, what's up? Kamusta kayong lahat mga kapatid, ano? And as always, ako po ay taos pusong nagpapasalamat at magpapasalamat sa patuloy niyo pong pagsusuporta sa aking munting channel, ano? Sa ating mga friends dyan, sa YT World, sa ating mga teams, lalong-lalo na po sa team ko, ang Team Joe Warot, sa panguna po ng aming napakasipag na founder na si Ma'am Mariposa Vlog, ano? Ay salamat po talaga sa inyo, sa ating mga members dyan, sa ating mga bisita, ano? So guys, paano mo ba minamanage ang iyong time? So ngayon po kasi, ang topic po nating i-discuss ngayon or ang video nating mapapanood ngayon ay itong tips kung paano i-manage ang ating time kagaya po ng mga mayayaman na tao. As far as I know po kasi, bilang isang financial educator, ano? O, ako po ay isang financial educator, rather, ano, under po ng International Marketing Group. Ang mga natutunan ko po doon ay napakarami po. Dapat marunong po tayong, unang-una na dyan, dapat tayong marunong mag-manage ng ating time. Kung talaga po tayo ay may matayag na pangarap sa ating buhay, unang-una po natin talagang i-manage ang ating time. Dapat po, marunong tayong mag-prioritize. Yun po. Una po yun. And then, dapat, alisin na natin yung ano, procrastination. Alam nyo po ba yung procrastination? Yung may mga bagay kasi tayong dapat na gawin, kung saan yung iba sa atin ay imbis na kayang gawin ngayon ay pinagpapabukas pa, 'di ba? So kung may mga bagay tayong dapat gawin ngayon, gawin na natin ngayon, wag na natin ipagpabukas pa, no? Kasi ang time po kasi ay napakalaking factor po para ma-achieve natin nating mga goals sa buhay, ano? And of course, dapat meron tayo mga short and long-term goal. Dapat marunong tayong magkaroon ng ganun, ano? Kung may mga may mga goals tayo, dapat marunong tayong i-prioritize po yun, ano? And with that, mga kapatid, para mapanood or malaman natin ang buong mga tips, ano, kung paano i-manage ang ating time, panoorin po natin yung video, ano? Kasi alam ko po kasi marami po talaga sa atin ang di alam kung paano bigyan ng significance or kahalagahan yung time, ano? Although tayo po bilang mga tao or ang pagkakaiba po ng tao at saka mayayaman, at sila po kasing mga mayayamang tao ay talagang binibigyan nila ng halaga ang time, ano? So every time, every minute talagang mahalaga po sa kanila. So tayo po bilang payaman pa lang, sana gayahin po natin sila, mga kapatid, ano? Kasi napakahalaga po talaga ng time, ano, sa buhay ng isang tao. So kapatid, kung ikaw ay bago naman dito sa aking channel, baka naman, sana naman huwag mong kalimutang i-like, i-comment, mag-comment, at i-click ang notification button, ano? Subscribe mo na rin, of course. Nang sa ganun ay maging updated ka, kapatid, kapag ka may mga bago po tayong videos, ano? So lagi po akong nagbibigay ng mga ganitong mga videos or mga advices, ano, dahil gusto ko pong makatulong sa inyo. So sana ang video ito ay magbigay sa atin ng aral o sa inyo ng aral, sa inyo dyan na mga manonood, sa pagbibigay ng kahalaga ng time. So tara po, panoorin na po natin.
One of the most significant determinants of success is your aptitude to managing time effectively. A lack of proper time management will amount to an inability to reach both personal and professional goals. Although both the poor and the rich have the same 24 hours every day, it is evident that they handle it differently. In this video, I will show you 13 tips that you can use to control your time like the rich people. 1. Prioritization. Most times, you find out that you have so many tasks that seem relevant to do, and it feels like 24 hours is too short a time to get those stuff done. You might even get so overwhelmed that you end up doing nothing. Regardless of why there are more tasks to complete than there are hours in a day, one thing remains certain. Sticking to your priorities can help you get more things done in less time. That is why Stephen Covey wrote, "The key is not to prioritize what's on your schedule, but to schedule your priorities." 2. Set short and long-term goals. To be able to maximize your time correctly, you must set desired goals for yourself. First of all, you have to establish long-term goals based on your priority. And then, for those goals to be measurable and attainable, it is paramount for you to break them down into short-term targets, monthly, weekly, and then daily. George T. Doran postulated the SMART technique, which is specific, measurable, achievable, relevant, and time-based way of goal setting, which the wealthy use to set their goals. 3. Differentiate between the urgent and the important. What do you do when your desk is full of loads of work? Do you rush into doing those that seem compelling to you? Well, that's not a correct way to tackle the situation. For you to have a productive day, you must first bear in mind that being busy is different from being productive. Find out which task keeps you busy and the one that makes you productive. The functions that keep you busy are in most cases the urgent ones. Hence, you must focus on the vital task. According to Stephen Covey, when you learn to fix important tasks, you are less likely to have future urgent tasks. 4. Have a simplified monthly schedule and break it into daily schedules. This is a continuation of the previous. Wealthy people understand the importance of plans and they use the KISS. Keep it simple. You can either use the crude method of pen and a journey book or digital applications. Some applications you can use to set your daily and monthly schedules are Trello, Evernote, etc. 5. Start with the most challenging task. When you set your schedule, do well to start with the most challenging task. In the book Eat That Frog, Brian Tracy emphasizes on the importance of starting with the ugliest frog. He wrote, "If you have to eat two frogs, eat the ugliest one first." The statement means that if you have two important tasks before you, start with the most robust, hardest, and most important task first. You may want to think that in finishing the simple task, you will be motivated to complete the harder ones. But on the contrary, it is smashing the difficult ones that gives you high spirit to do the others. 6. Spend time with family. Contrary to the perception of many people that the rich do not have time for family, they do create time for their family. Even though he works 80 hours plus during the week running Tesla and SpaceX, Elon Musk hangs out with his 5 sons on weekends. American billionaire Mark Cuban also does the same, and so do many other millionaires and billionaires. Microsoft chairman Bill Gates once said, "Making out spare time to look towards the precious things you have, pastimes and family, makes life more satisfying. It also helps you to concentrate better at work." 7. Networking. Attending events and programs is one thing that rich people invest their time on. Rich men are often selective of the places they go. They are not your everyday people. Often, they are seen in gatherings where other millionaires are. The reason being that they understand networking and its positive impacts on their lives. They attend conferences not just because of information. It is a strategy for them to meet other individuals and get contacts that will be beneficial to them and their businesses. 8. Fix time limits for lower tasks. Most productive people do not just make schedules. They designate time for each program and often set a time limit for the less important one. For instance, instead of letting emails suck up the morning, limit yourself to checking and responding to an email at a particular time of the day for a specified period. This one hack will give you more time to devote to more significant issues and projects. 9. Delegate tasks that you can delegate. This is why you must learn to interact with people and build mutual relationships. No man is an island. Everyone needs help at some point in time. If you are in a leadership position, you will get worn out if you try to do everything by yourself. You must learn, comprehend, and apply the principle of delegation if you want to be successful. However, Not every task ought to be delegated, and you must trust the person enough. Also ensure that the people whom you delegate tasks to carry them out willingly and not forcefully, so you don't have to redo them. 10. Spend time to recharge yourself. Time for meditation and self-examination is mandatory for the rich. They take out some time to refresh themselves by reading books, revisiting their life's mission, recreational activities, building their spirituality, learning skills, and speaking affirmations. Recharging is an essential activity for the rich. Thus, they do not rush through it. If you spend enough time recharging yourself, you won't have to waste time doing unnecessary things because recharging helps you remember your goals, your targets, and your priorities. 11. Avoid procrastination. Don't take to tomorrow what you can do today, because tomorrow has its activities. The rich understand that procrastination is a thief of time, so they try as much as they can to avoid it. Once you put something on your priority list for the day, endeavor to do it. When you postpone activities, you are creating for yourself a long list of tasks on your urgent column, and that translates to having to focus on the immediate. Pablo Picasso once advised that only put off until tomorrow what you are willing to die having left undone. 12. Don't waste time chattering. So, this is a sensitive aspect and self-control is highly needed. Many a time, what takes your time are those conversations that were not necessary. It is a big challenge for individuals of the sanguine temperament. Most times, they get deeply engrossed in chatters that they forget what they were formerly doing. Those brief conversations you usually engage in eat up into the time you're supposed to spend carrying out relevant activities. 13. Learn to rest and take a break. Anne Lamott once said, "Almost everything will work again if you unplug it for a few minutes, including you. If you do not take out time to rest, you might end up being forced to sleep on the sickbed." The rich always include rests and doctor's appointments on their schedules. They understand that at the end, it's not the hard workers that are rich, but the smart workers. So, they place their health as priority and endeavor to give their body rest from time to time. If you do not want to be part of the 92% of the world's population who fail to achieve their goals, then you need to pay attention to the way you use the precious time you have.